I can't think with all the background noise. White noise. Hey everyone, Amy here with you on D News today. I am so super envious of people who can sleep through anything. Thankfully, white noise apps exist so I can take a decent night's sleep with me on the road. But why exactly does it help? To understand how white noise helps you sleep, we need to take a step back and look at how sound and hearing work first. Sound is a wave that moves through the air, vibrating molecules as it goes along. The vibrations hit the eardrums, then pass through the inner ear, where cells called hair cells change the vibrations into electrical signals. These signals go into the brain and tell you what sound you're hearing. The frequency of that wave, technically speaking, how often the particle's vibrations repeat in 1 second, is measured in hertz. Humans can hear sounds from 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz, and the higher the frequency, the higher the note you hear, and also the less easy it is to ignore. And these hearing faculties still work when you're sleeping. Even if you're not awake, your brain can register significant sounds. So when you hear a noise at night and it wakes you up, it's the sudden change in frequency of background noise that disturbs your sleeping brain. So how can you stop those sudden frequency sounds from ripping you out of dreamland? We're back to white noise. White noise, properly speaking, is a constant noise that covers all hearable frequencies at once at a constant power rate per hertz. Its frequency spectrum is completely flat, so no new sound can be heard over it, if it's playing loud enough, of course. White noise essentially masks all other sounds, and that's where it gets its name. White noise is analogous to white light. White light is all wavelengths of light, and white noise is all frequencies of sound. So because it's characterized as constant noise with equal power across all frequencies, that means some sounds that people call white noise aren't. The hum of an airplane engine, for example, or the pitter-patter of rainfall. They're soothing sounds that block out some noise, but they aren't true white noise. But white noise isn't the only color of sound. There are others, and like how colored light is a specific wavelength, colors of noise focus on specific frequencies. And some research suggests that pink noise is actually a better sleep sound than white noise. Like white noise, pink noise contains all frequencies audible to human ears, but the power per hertz decreases as the frequency increases. It's a subtle difference. So here's what white noise sounds like. And here's what pink noise sounds like. And when you play them back to back, you can hear the difference. In a small study of 11 subjects, a team of German researchers played pink noise in synchronicity with sleeping subjects' brain rhythms. When compared to a control that had no sound stimulation, the pink noise seemed to prolong deep sleep and enhance memory retention in the morning. There are other colors of noise, too, corresponding to different frequencies, like how colored light focuses on different wavelengths. There's red or brown noise, blue noise, violet, black, green, and orange noise, though I didn't find any research about how well they might help you sleep. So why do we find white noise soothing? Well, it's a personal preference thing. Some people love white noise and some hate it, but most people find it helpful for sleep because of its ability to mask other sounds. And really, don't we all just want a nice, quiet night's sleep? Sound is pretty neat, and because it's a physical wave, it can do some weird things. Trace talks about some of the amazing things sound waves can do in this video right here.
This works only when the sound wave is at the exact same frequency as the object you're shooting at. If you gently flick a wine glass with your fingernail, you will hear its frequency. Match that tone and turn the volume up, way, way up to like 11, and that glass will probably break.
So do you guys love or hate sleeping with white noise? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to D News so you never miss an episode.